Hi everybody, this will be my first time playing Resident Evil 7. I'm going into this game completely blind. A bunch of people have played this game, and I wish I would have got onto it earlier when they were playing it as well. But as they say, better late than never. Now that I got my tax return, I can, and thanks to Michelle buying it for me beforehand, before I got my tax return. Thank you, Michelle. I love you, Pepe. I'll be playing this now. I finally have the chance. And, let's see. Not visible, barely visible. Okay. So. Let's see. I'm just in. Okay. Oh, that adjusted the size of the screen. Okay. Okay, good. It's a completely free service that gives you a deeper look in the Resident Evil universe, my gear, mark, and your series records, complete rankings. Sure. Okay, now I've played a lot of the Resident Evil games. I started out, the first game I played was Resident Evil 2 back on the N64. That was way back. And I liked that game back then. I liked the survival horror elements. The spiders freaked me out, though. I have arachnophobia. Part of me says, you know, thinks I shouldn't say that because people are gonna bug me about that now. But yeah, I had a tough time getting through that because of the spiders. But the rest of the game, I loved. I liked being scared. And then I played the ones on GameCube. Now, in my opinion, the original one on GameCube, Resident Evil Remake, that they remade the first one. In my opinion, that's the best survival horror Resident Evil game. And then later on, Resident Evil 4 came out, and I played that a lot, probably because there's not a lot of spiders, but also I like the action elements and I like the RPG elements. But then they went too far with Resident Evil 5, that went away from the survival horror, and then with Resident Evil 6, I think there was a disconnect there. And so after that, I think the only thing that's better than at Resident Evil 5 than Resident Evil 4 is the fact that, you know, there's not Ashley, who's annoying, and there's also Albert Wesker, and then there's the Hydra. But aside from that, I think Resident Evil 4 is better than Resident Evil 5. But so, I'm not... let me see. What do you think? Should I go easy or normal, maybe? Probably easy for my first Let's Play through, huh?
Yeah, I'm super
easy. Yeah.
Hi, guys!
Yeah, but this is my first playthrough, so I have no idea what to expect. Markiplier is one of the ones that came out with Resident Evil 7 Let's Play, and I wanted to watch him so bad. But
hey,
I don't know what to expect.
A quick hello, and I love you. Oh, good news. I'm going to be coming home soon. Yay!
Wow. The graphics are amazing. That's one of the things that Resident Evil is really known for, is their graphics.
I gotta get back to work. I love you, Ethan. I miss you so much. I'm sending...
It's crazy. The graphics in this game are... Watching on my laptop. Oh, yeah. Now, go to another website. Come on, you know you want to. No. You look scared now.
Yeah.
Panicking.
I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is that if you get this, stay away
from American Idol. Stay away from American Idol. Stay away from Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber is terrible.
Hello?
Hey, it's Ethan.
Oh, hey. You alright? You just disappeared the other day.
Wow.
Yeah, no, I'm good. It's Mia. She's not dead, she's alive. She's back.
She's alive? My God.
What happened?
I don't
know. Wow, look at that skyline.
I don't know how.
The graphics are...
Somehow.
This lake is beautiful.
Maybe it's a prank. She wants me to come and get her.
I bet someone else sent the word to bring him over there. Graphics are amazing, though.
I have to find out what happened.
For some reason, I'm not getting the volume through my microphone, through my headphones, so hopefully... Oh, right stick to look around. Huh? Yeah, I can hear myself through the microphone. I just can't hear the audio of the game. It's weird. But I can hear enough through the TV playing, so... This looks realistic. This reminds me of Resident Evil 4, because Resident Evil 4 started out with a similar scenario in terms of driving to a place you're supposed to be at, and you can't go any further. I got an achievement. She's alive. Travel to Louisiana. Well, there's the item slots. Mia Winters. July 18, 2017. 11:04, Tuesday, Ethan Winters. Come get me. Come get me, Ethan. I'm gonna make you sick, Ethan. I'm gonna die. Okay, I'm done. Okay. Oh, there's hotkey buttons. That's cool. I'm a hotkey. No, I don't know. Let's see. Let's test a... Ooh, dance. Dance for the people at home. Now, this is interesting because I just remember just now the big difference between this and all the other Resident Evil games that we played so far. There's only been a very, very few that have ever done first before. Most of them have been over the shoulder. I'm guessing this is the defense one or this is the dancing one. Oonch, 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 oonch. Dance to death now. Oonch, oonch, oonch. Dance to the death. Dance to the death. Okay. Now, run buttons, anything at all? The only thing I can do is do the defense thing. That's all I know to do so far. Check my objective. Okay, find me. I've got the map. Bring back the map. Bring back what you have stolen. Oh, is a little creepy girl gonna be in front? Is she gonna be in front of here? Let's explore down this way. Wish I could run. I feel like... Oh! My prayers have been answered. Left stick. Except they're hurt. Death is your gift. If you've ever seen Buffy the Vampire Slayer, the fifth season, you'll know what I'm talking about for Buffy fans. Death is your gift. Shoot flies. Don't bother me no more. The graphics in this game are just amazing. Uh-oh. Come on. Is there going to be a cutscene? I'm going to get some things over here. Ed. Oh, shoot. Our damn crows over there. Staple of Resident Evil are the crows. Yes. Ooh. I don't know about you guys, but after all this walking, I'm kind of hungry. Yay. Right stick is crouch. Left stick is run. Options. Oh, controls. This is easier, actually. Camera speed is 4. Invert. Display. Blood on screen. Camera wobble. Yeah, it's there's going to be a... I might practice later on off-screen so you guys won't be, like, yelling at the screen, "This is how you're supposed to do it, you fool." And it'll be like, "Hey, derp, no, herp, derp, derp." Please don't be mad at me. I love you guys. It's my day off, and I figured what better way to play Resident Evil. This came just in the mail today, and so I figured what better way than to drink Angry Orchard or the cider drink is what I'm supposed to say, off-brand cider drink, to all the people. It's really good, especially if you mix it with Fireball. There we go. I found a secret. My UPS truck came just in time. Sewer Gators. Left stick is to rotate. Right. Project was sneaking to a join us. Now, is that written in lipstick? I know it's written in lipstick. That's right. Whoever just got that has got their penmanship down. I mean, if you're going for a crazy person that's writing in blood, that's kind of neat. That person took a calligraphy class or something. Join us or die, Spud of Satan. Okay. Oh, the other difference between this one and the other Resident Evil... Can I climb this thing? The other difference between this one and all the Resident Evil ones, I don't know if Resident Evil 6 did this or not, but when you start, there's a guy in that dramatic voice that always announces the Resident Evil title you're playing. Like, he'll be like, Resident Evil 4. Resident Evil. Kardashian Edition. Or something crazy like that, yeah. Okay, now that I've done enough detours, I might be missing a part somewhere. Oh no, Cletus, what shall we do? Come on. Am I supposed to find like a crowbar or something? Okay. I've done messed up, Cletus. I've done messed up again. Opie Taylor, where are you? Okay. I know some of you guys, I appreciate your patience. Like I said, this is a blind game. And that does not mean I literally am blind. I'm just playing with no information at all on this except for what I've seen in trailers. So, some of you will be mad at me. Now, non-spoiler tips are great. Now, as far as story tips, then I don't. Now, I figure at some point, there, with my luck, there's going to be some spiders, but I'm hoping they're not massive tarantula-sized ones, the other ones. And if that happens, I'll find my way through it. Did an A button thing pop up? No. Herp-a-derp, walk-in. And walk-in, and walk-in. Okay. Is there like a back way? Did I miss a crowbar here or something? Did I miss a chain? Ah. Okay, there's not a chain. Accept her gift. What does that mean? I won't accept it. I figure, like, I'm making some stupid, simple mistake. You guys are gonna be mad. This is how it usually starts. Like, when I played Resident Evil 4 the first time, I did not know what I was doing. I was so used to the survival horror Resident Evil games that when it came to the action-oriented part, like, I died in the village that you first start out. I think I've come to a clearing. So I think I've come across luck. Now, if I was doing things right, I should have looked at the map. That would be the first clue. That could help, actually. Bring back the map. Bring back the map. That's a reference to the movie Time Bandits. It's a movie a long time ago. Now, did I miss something here? Is there, like, some type of... I know I gotta be missing something. It's gotta be like a crowbar or something. Or maybe I had to try more times than the... But yeah, I remember the first time I played Resident Evil 4, I had no idea what I was doing. No clue at all. Oh, crouch. You crouch underneath. I am such a I'm dumb. I am herp-a-derp all the way. I wonder why they were saying... I'm gonna see if I might edit that part out. I might. But then again, I might not. Life is a mystery in so many ways. Up. Steam, there's a fire. Where there's smoke, there's a fire, not steam. Steam, fool. Uh-oh. Yeah, this, I'm having heavy Resident Evil 4 vibes right now. Big, massive Resident Evil 4 vibes. So far, I like this game. First-person perspective. Now, I wonder if there are going to be... if there's going to be any... oh, driver's license. Okay. Aha. It was Colonel Mustard with a nightstick, with a candlestick. In the observatory. Evidently, he stole the nightstick from a police guy. Thing. Person. Woman. I don't, man. Creature. Okay. Now, what does that do? I got a driver's license.
What?
I got a driver's license.
Oh, I thought you were talking about me.
Look. Oh, coincidentally, Michelle just got her driver's license. Do you want to say anything, Michelle?
I got my license. I've been drinking more of this than you.
Yeah, she's been drinking more of the Green Orchard than I have. I'm trying to keep my wits about me, and that paid off with the crouching thing.
Beer?
No, I'm going to drink it all. I'm not going to waste it. But yeah, there's the driver's license now. What was I saying? I wonder if there's going to be RPG elements, because that was my favorite part about Resident Evil 4 and Resident Evil 5 compared to the others, and that was one of the reasons why I liked Resident Evil 4 and 5 compared to the original ones, because you can upgrade your weapons, and I love doing that. So I know they're definitely, after the reception of Resident Evil 6, they're going right back to back to the survival horror. I know they're going heavy. Oh, let's swing. I'm a swing. No, I'm not a, no. I'm not a swing, no.
Yeah, you are.
I'm a one woman. I'm a, yeah. I'm a mate for life kind of guy. Let's see. But I'll do me, and other people will do themselves. Do what they want to do. Ooh, shadows. Coming into the dark room, don't know what to expect. This is a spooky part. This is the spookiest part so far, other than that creepy guy showing up. Oh, we got my flashlight. Okay, Linda Blair, do not come out.
But I want Nick.
No, you can't come out yet. Not yet. Come out. Yeah, you should watch this, Michelle. This is seriously, this is getting the creepers going. Look, there's a heart.
Oh, fuck you. You always make me watch this. I'm gonna jump out.
There's a, uh-oh. I'll use my driver's license. It won't cut it. I'll use the paper thing. I'll use my teeth. I'll be like Jaws from James Bond. Bite through that. Okay. Now I have a feeling. Yep, here we go. Here's the gross stuff. A dead crow for lunch. Reminds me of the Shane Dawson. Oh yeah, the refrigerator is a gross part. I would not recommend anyone who's eating anything, do not look at this part.
Oh.
Yeah. Now, I grew up, my families were hoarders, but they never got nearly this bad growing up. Never nearly this bad. It was messy, but this makes my family look like minimalist extra. I would not open.
Do it.
Okay. I do not recommend you eat while you're watching this stuff.
Oh, fuck. That was funny.
Yeah, my girlfriend's laughing right now. I don't know if you're able to pick that up on the mic or not. Over 20 missing in a year. In 2 years. I missed that. So that's 10 per year. I can do my math.
Drink the whole thing.
Wow, Michelle drank one bottle already of the cider mix.
This is my shit.
The cider mix that's both angry and hard. The orchard cider mix.
Hard.
I was making a stupid joke or something. Now this is a burnt photo. Someone's coming in the window. It's a creepy lady. Looks like a Mars face. I feel like someone's gonna sneak up on me. I can't take it. Whatever it is, I can't take it with me. I'm gonna turn around. There's gonna be Cletus right behind me. Now, this also, as some people I think have pointed out, not in reviews, but in I've opened this up already. I don't need to open that stuff again. Close it.
Are we watching you?
Nobody's watching me on Twitch right now. What I do is a trick. This is John Hightower recommended this trick to us. Is we broadcast on Twitch and then we save it and then we download it to YouTube. So it's an efficient double whammy. We don't have to do much. So this is the scariest part so far. I mean, I'm not really terrified, but I'm thinking something's gonna pop up. It's like the quiet before the storm. You know, something's bound to happen. They gave us a little spook with that guy that was walking by and then he was gone. So you know something's going to happen at first. Now, I could have gone upstairs, but for me, I don't know, everyone's different, but me, I like to check the downstairs part first, and then I move my way up. Oh, yeah. No, joking. Nah. No, she's nowhere near as good as Michelle is. Not on the best day. There's two of them here. Someone was fapping here. Someone was sitting here. That's why the sofa looks all messed up. Someone was sitting here and they were fapping.
What's fapping?
Oh, my Michelle asked what's fapping. It's a term.
Oh, I know what it is.
Yeah, it's the sound. Fap, 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 fap.
Yeah.
Let's see. Wow, someone really likes doors. I think what they're trying to get at with these pictures and this one of the chain link is that she's in that prison now, is what they're trying to. I think that's what they're trying to go for, as far as showing that. Oh my God, that looks like the owners. He's got that creepy stare. There's a TV over here. Let me see if Andy Griffith is on or Matlock. No Andy Griffith today. Now, for the record, I know people are gonna get. I like Andy Griffith show. I used to watch that show. I like that show. I just think because of the environment, it's set in Louisiana and that kind of thing, and I thought it'd be funny to say that. This is what builds up anticipation: is the silent moments. You're setting up an expectation with that guy that walked past in the clearing in the wilderness. Then you have this eerily silent thing where you're expecting, I know it's going to happen, but when? When is it going to happen? And watch the demo. That's the only thing I've watched as far as, then this one, I know mannequins come up from there, but there's no power right now. So this one's going to start off slow. Oh, this is how you save. This is replace the typewriter. I can save with this. Awesome. Yeah, at Resident Evil 4 there was a typewriter. At Resident Evil 5 there wasn't a typewriter, but it would save in checkpoints. Oh, yep, here's the derelict house footage. I remember from the demo how this goes down. Is someone going to be there with an axe or walk by? Is someone going to be like, welcome to the family soon? And they'll make me eat a bucket of KFC. Or Popeyes. If they had turkey, I'd eat it. No, I wouldn't. Not even with turkey. Okay. This is where it's going to get really ramp up, because I got the VHS now, baby. VHS tape, I'm going to put it in now. It's going to get really scary now. This is where...
Yeah, this is where I stop watching.
You don't want to watch, baby?
This
is the funny thing about I love this is the funny thing about Michelle. She'll watch like documentaries, like murder documentaries all the time.
This is so true. But, I didn't even think about that.
But when it comes to like fake stuff, like fictional stuff, I'll watch creepy pastas and all that. She's gonna explain why.
I'll tell you guys why. This is why. In shit like this, something is gonna jump out at you. There's gonna be some kind of a jump scare, right?
Right.
Documentaries.
They don't
that
have.
Shit doesn't
they don't
happen.
Have jump scares.
I hate jump scares.
Even though it's real, yeah.
Even though it's real, and I know that evil exists.
Right.
As long as it's not jumping out at me, I'm fine.
I love you,
which
baby.
Is funny because I love Halloween Haunt. So yeah. Figure that one out.
Because you know you're in a safe environment.
We have to go next year, maybe.
Yeah, we'll go next year. We'll probably tape it. I love you, baby.
Got your computer?
Yeah, I got my computer today. So yeah, if you haven't heard, that's her explanation. Is when she's watching documentaries, even though they're true, and that's scary because you watch this stuff and you kind of start to become you can become paranoid and think, you know. But there's no jump scares to it. And I watch creepypastas for the opposite reason, because I know they're not true and they're all fictional. For the most part, most of them are. I'd say like 99% of creepypastas are fictional. But yeah, this part I'm not completely blind on. Because I've watched some people play the demo. So I'm not blind at that part. The full game I am, but not the demo part. And I remember these guys. These guys are... These guys are gonna die. And you're gonna see some scary images that will flick out at some points. And if you want to pause your screen to see them, you can. But they are freaky. Let's chain shut.
Clancy, get a shot of this. Let's make a great cutaway. So, Hillbilly Joe and his family go missing. Not Hillbilly, it's the Bakers. Jack and Marguerite Baker. They were quiet.
Move, you darn. I can't open this. Okay. Now, I know there's a drawer, if I remember right from the demo. It's been so long since I watched the demo. Been a long time. Okay, now nope, nothing in the microwave. Darn. Yeah, the still bad. Okay, let's see. No.
I told them that she frustrated me because they weren't home. Sorry. I'm sorry.
This is the last time I work with that
guy. I'm trying to find an item.
I mean, producers, they come.
It's okay, boo. Good cameraman, like trying to find the item that I'm supposed to find, but I can't find it for some reason. So it might not be like the demos, actually. Or if it is, and I can't get the essential item right now, I'm a dum-dum. And I might have to replay again. I'm not opening that. Nope. I'm opening this one. I make the choices. Nope. I don't make the choices. Andre's dead. He's a dead man. That's what he is. Andre's a gone. Yeah. Ooh.
What the hell? You gotta be fucking kidding me. All right, new deal. Andre and we go. I mean, fuck this show.
Now, what if I go back? I think I can go back. Go up there now. Let's see. How long I've been playing? I might want to split up this part.
It's 9.
Shoot. I'm just going to stop it here for right now. And then I'll do part 2, yeah.